and welcome to the Green Horde. I'm the Everlast, and I have here a nice little box from Silent Night Games in Austria. And this is a real tank hunter, the A10 Thunderbolt 2, also known as Warthog. This little tank killer gets me into the blue, not on the ground. And as much T-72 tanks I have in my bag, like the 10 from the starter box, this little nice plane will reduce him to rubble. So what we've got in this box, it contains two planes, two flight stands, one decal sheet, four rare earth magnets, and the unit card. So, we will take a look inside this box and see you then. So, let's have a look inside this nice box. So packed in the big plastic boxes we know from Battlefront. On top you see already the unit card and the decal sheet. Okay, the decal sheet, we have only one, and this has the US Air Force emblems and the Warthog teeth. So let's head over to the unit card. So we have here the stats for the A10. With the morale, courage, skill, is hit on, aircraft safe. So we have an unlimited movement, tactical terrain dash, road and so on. Then we have down here the weapons, the big Gatling. It's an anti-helicopter, so it's a Hindhunter also. Then the Maverick missiles, they are guided and have heat. And also down here the cluster bombs. Cluster bombs only shoot once in a bomb run, one shot weapon. So on the back side we have the points with 10 points for 2 A10. They are not cheap, but a good tank hunter. So we have anti-helicopter, all the special rules you have here. So, let's check the content of the box. So we have two main fuselage with the wings and the cockpit. So then we have the turbofans. And so the front parts of the turbofans. And here, be careful, there are magnets. There are magnets inside, four of these. So down there are stored the flight stands with a long flight pack, because we have high flying aircraft. Okay, the A10 is capable of flying very, very low, but he doesn't assault infantry. Like you have seen the video of the German Bo 105, the Flying Tiger, on the Battlefront website. This chopper, this German chopper, is the only ones who will get an assault with infantry. So, then we have here the loadout for the underwing hardpoints. So let's head over to the main parts. What is very prominent to see is you have two colors of resin. Truly resin. Battlefront was always making some hull parts in resin and the rest in white metal, but we have here all in resin, no white metal is left in this box. So we have the darker resin for the fuselage, for the cockpit, and the wings, for the main parts. It's a very strong one. You see here some details, the hard points. You can even see the mighty Gatling. And here over there. And these parts will get together in this way. And I'm seeing here on there is some space then left. There you have W needs some green stuff, and I have noticed some flash or a miscast here at the end. Do you see this? I have in comparison the other one, and yeah, maybe some. Oh, and here on the turbofan we have an also a little miscast. But incomplete. I'm not. I did get the better models. A friend of me, El Uruk, did get not the best models. So one moment, I'm making camera sharp. He has more problems with the cast, and there are more. They are not as good as mine, so I say I'm really lucky. So we have here some part. So, and then we have here the front of the turbofans. They are gonna attach like this. So here and here. And will look like this. So, and then we have the weapon loadout. We have at least 12 Maverick missiles. Makes a loadout of 6 Maverick missiles for each plane, and let's see how much cluster bombs we have. We have 8 cluster bombs to get 4 on each plane. Yeah, that's a nice loadout for tank hunting. Not only for Western Germany, maybe for tank hunting in the second Iraq war. I say Desert Storm. or did say someone Desert Storm? Okay, I didn't hear it. Okay, a nice little kit, nice little box with 2 mighty, mighty ground attack strike aircraft. And I hope I will have glued them together in no time and painted and ready to use against some Soviet tank battalion. So, this was the Everlast from the Green Horde. I will say thank you for watching. If you have comments, write them down under this video. And see you. Bye.